I'm Sveta Kletina from Shoemaking Courses Online. In today's video, we're gonna make sandals without any special equipment, working only with simple tools and your feet. Now, this tutorial is a little bit different from what I usually do in this channel, in my shoemaking courses online, but I decided to upgrade my oldest YouTube tutorial. Now, before we're gonna make these sandals, please make sure to subscribe to my channel here, and of course, click the bell button to know when my new video will come out, because I post almost weekly new tutorials, new videos. So, let's start. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. We will make the sandal using our feet. So to know what is the shape of the insole that we will use for our sandal, we need to place feet on some paper and design the outline of the feet. And later we'll use this outline to make insole and shoe sole for these sandals. So, place your feet on the paper and draw outline of your feet. Then, use this drawing and make pattern for the insole. You can reduce slightly the shape of this insole, of this outline of your feet to make the insole. Total in 5 millimeters, so you can cut 2 millimeters on one side from one side and 2 millimeters from the other side to reduce a little bit the line for the insole, so you will have a beautiful, not so wide insole. We don't need to have such a wide insole here. Okay, so I repeat it again, you can reduce it on 5 millimeters total. Now, regarding the toe shape, I use here rounded toe shape. I followed the shape of the toe that I have. You can change the line. You can make it with square toe, with pointed toe, as you wish. Just use the outline of your feet as a reference to know what is the length of the insole, and then you can change it according to the sandal design that you want to create. Okay, so you can change the toe shape and make different styles of your sandals. If you will cut it not accurately, you can work on it a little bit with sandpaper. Okay, so sand places where it's not smooth with sandpaper. Now we will cut 5 strips from paper. I use here 5 strips because I choose this design of the sandals. You can make many other straps, or you can reduce the amount of straps. Also, you can change the width of the straps. Okay, here you can take this idea and make your own sandals. So here I used 4 straps with width of 2 centimeters and 1 strap with the width of 1 centimeter, and cut these straps from paper, make them long enough so you will have enough paper straps to place it on your feet. It's very easy, just cut straps with the width that you will choose for your sandals, and also place numbers on the straps so you will know later how to make pattern for each of these straps. This one I assembled, two straps I attached together because I didn't have enough long enough strap. That's why I just simply attached 2 pieces of strap. So in total we have 4 straps, because 1 strap we unified to make this strap longer. And then we will place all the straps from paper on the feet to mark the length of each strap and to know the right placement of each strap that we will gonna attach later to the insole. So we need to know each place of each strap. That's why now we'll use our feet to know it. So place your feet now on the insole that you made. Take all these straps and place it on your feet following the design that you choose. You see here I have this design of the sandals. You can make it differently. You can make just these two straps in front of your sandals, or make it, place it differently, place it parallel, two parallel lines, two parallel straps. Okay, so here you will decide what design of your sandals you will make, but the process is the same. So after you will learn how to make this type of sandals, this design of sandals, you may upgrade it and make different styles of designs working with your feet without any equipment. Okay, so what is important here is to place straps correctly. Remember, in this moment when you place the paper straps on your feet, pay attention how you place strap that will hold your pinky toe. It's very important because the strap must really hold your pinky toe so it will not pop out during wearing these sandals. Maybe you saw sandals where pinky toe pops out from the sandals and it looks ugly. So during your making, pay attention how you place the strap. It's very important. Strap must hold the pinky toe. Okay, it must cover it. It can cover the pinky toe. Pinky toe may you can see it a little bit, but it must hold it. Okay, now let's move on. So place it in the way how you design, how you design the sandals. I repeat it again, I use this design of sandal. You can change it and make it a little bit differently. Now use different colors of markers because it will help you to understand which strap belongs to which side, to know how to attach each strap during lasting, when we will attach the straps to the insole. Okay, so with each marker with certain color, mark edge of the straps on the insole, and with different colors it will be much easier to understand which strap belongs to which side of the insole. Okay, so just match, just mark each edge of the strap on the insole. Also I use here this narrow strap that will hold the ankle strap. Okay, now pay attention here. I will make now mark of the inner side. It's very important because we have outer side and inner side. Let's look on the last. This is sandal last, and when we make sandals professionally, we work with shoe last, and this is sandal last. So to make it easier, we divide our shoe last on outer side and inner side. In sandals also you will attach straps on outer side in one way, in inner side in different way. That's why you should mark on the straps the inner side of each strap. That means each strap that lays on the inner side of your feet, you should mark with this kind of mark. Just make a V to know that this strap belongs to the inner side of your sandals. You see here and here, each of the straps we need to mark the inner side on each strap that is on the inner side of our sandals. Okay, also this sandal will have buckle, so mark a placement of the buckle a little bit behind the beginning of the ankle bone. Okay, also on each strap mark the edge of the insole. Later, according to this mark, the mark of the insole edge, you will know how to attach each strap to the insole. Okay, so let's continue. After you will make all these patterns, check each mark on the insole to understand that you marked it correctly. So each mark with the needed color will represent the correct strap. And then, after you will be sure that you marked it correctly, move on to this strap that we have on the heel. Mark to know where to place it correctly. By your eyes, find on the insole, in the edge of the insole, in the heel part, center. And then place to the center point the strap that we made for the back part. The strap that you have on the back, okay? So place it in the way where center of the strap match the center of the insole and mark the edge of the strap on the insole. Now we move on to make patterns from cardboard, because this was only paper pattern. Now, if you want to know more about different techniques in pattern making, in shoemaking, to know why I use simple paper A4 in shoemaking, make sure to check all my videos that I made. And of course, if you want to know when my new video will be ready for you, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and of course click the bell button to know, to get a notification when my new video will come out. Okay, so let's continue with the pattern making. Now, to cut all these straps, very easy. You should transfer all these paper straps with each marks that each strap has to the cardboard, because cardboard is more stable material, and working with cardboard, you will cut all leather pieces very easy. So that's why now we will make, let's say, basic patterns of all these straps. So what is basic pattern? I also made a lot of tutorials about different basic patterns, so don't forget to browse in my channel and you will find there many different tutorials about basic pattern too. Okay, now let's continue. You just need to transfer all these marks that we have on each strap. Now, here in this, in making of this strap, pay attention on this detail. Here this strap will enter inside of the buckle. So now we have only mark of the buckle, and we need to add extra material, extra strap, to have big enough strap that will close on each width of the, on different feet, on your feet, on other feet. So we need to have extra allowance to close it tightly or to open it more. That's why we need to add here 45 millimeters to this mark that we made on this strap. Okay, and later in this detail that we added, we will make holes to enter it inside of the buckle. Okay, and in this edge of the strap, I made rounded shape. You can make it straight. Now, in this place where you see it's rolled 1.5 centimeters, this extra we need to have to attach each edge of the strap to the insole. We call it, in professional shoemaking, we call it lasting allowance. Lasting allowance will allow us to bend the edge, to attach each edge of the upper to the insole. Right now we had only mark of the insole, so in order to attach each strap, we need to add 15-20 millimeters, okay, and it will be our lasting allowance. Okay, now, so make this lasting allowance with the line that parallel to the mark that we have on the strap, and cut out each strap. Here we will need to mark also the inner side of the straps that have this mark. You remember, we mark with this kind of mark V, that has V shape, the inner side of the sandal. And we need to have this mark also in this cardboard pattern. So later we will understand, according to these marks, that these straps that we have, this mark, belong to the inner side of our sandal. Okay, so don't forget to make this mark. And cut out this strap. Also here we need to make this cut here. And it, using this cut, we will know, we will mark it on the leather, and according to this mark that we will have on leather, we will know how to attach our straps. Okay, this is approach that I invented in this sandal making, where we don't use shoelace and use our feet. So we will attach it without any shoelace, and to know how to attach it exactly, where to place glue, we need to have this mark. And to transfer this mark to the leather, make a cut like I show it in the video, to in order to enter some pencil or pen into this mark and mark it on leather. Okay, so here also, now you see we need to make marks for the holes. So mark 5 millimeters from the mark that you have for the buckle on each side, and then for each other hole measure 1 centimeter. It can be also 8 millimeters or 1 centimeter for each new hole. And don't forget to mark a number for each strap. Now we need to make pattern for this strap. Just transfer this strap, and don't forget to add here in this place, you see, we need to add 4 centimeters for the buckle. I use here a little bit big buckle. So to hold this buckle, I need to have extra that will overlap the buckle, and we will attach it to the inner side of the strap. So in this strap, and in the strap where in the strap that you will make that will hold the buckle, add extra 4-3 centimeters. It depends on the measurement of the buckle. If it big buckle, add 4 centimeters. If you will use a little bit smaller buckle, you can reduce this measurement. Okay, now let's continue. Here just make narrow the edge so it will not extend after we will bend it. And don't forget to have this mark of lasting allowance, and also don't forget to mark the number of the strap. Now here, now is our strap that we have in the back part. And this strap will hold the strap with the buckle. So we will need to make a kind of loop. Right now this strap has only marks of the edge of the insole and the top edge of the strap. So we will need to add extra to be possible create a loop. And to make this loop, use strap, the width of the strap that will pass through this loop. So that's why to this top edge of the strap, place the strap that will pass through this loop and mark twice the width of the strap. Don't forget to make these marks on the cardboard, so you will know how to bend the strap to create this loop. And also to the extra that you added to the strap, the extra width that you added for the strap, add another few millimeters to attach this edge and close the loop. And usually we add, it's called underline, and usually we add for underline 8 millimeters. And of course, lasting allowance you need to add. Then make all needed marks. Here is the mark of the edge. This is underline. You see this mark for underline. So according to this mark, we will know where to place glue to attach this strap and create loop. Here, this mark is the middle of our loop, is the actually the top line of this back strap. Now you will see how it will look. You see this loop we created. So after you will follow all the steps, you will have here this loop, and you will be able to place inside of this loop strap. Now we are making another pattern for the strap, following the same steps. Mark the edge, mark the inner side if it has, and don't forget to place a number of each strap. And cut out. This is the elastic allowance, mark of the elastic allowance, know how to attach it to the insole, and number of the strap. So we have now these basic patterns of each strap. And here in this approach, we will make each strap with the raw cut. To create beautiful raw cut with accurate edge, we should enlarge each strap, and then after we will attach each part of this enlarged leather strap, we will use these basic patterns of each strap to cut it, and we will get the original width. This approach is a professional approach, and we do straps with raw cut like this when we cut a little bit bigger pieces of leather. We attach them together, and using our original strap, the pattern of original strap with the original width, we cut this extra, and this is how we will get beautiful and accurate raw edge. Also, using this approach, it will be very easy for you to attach pieces, because you will not need to work with small narrow pieces of leather. You will use a little bit bigger pieces, and you will work much easier. Okay, so that's why you can enlarge it by eyes on few millimeters. It's enough to enlarge it on 5-6 millimeters. Also, in the edge of the elastic allowance, you can enlarge it on 2 millimeters. It's enough. So place each strap on the cardboard and enlarge it around to have a little bit bigger pieces, bigger straps. And don't forget to mark also the number for each cardboard pattern. And all these straps, bigger straps that we got, we will cut twice. But you will see it right now. So, okay, don't forget to mark numbers. And you saw that our original pattern is smaller than the pattern that we just created. Now we will cut all these bigger straps, and if you want to cut it easier, use one of the approaches that I taught in one of my tutorials, and a link to this tutorial you can find in the description below. And that's why it's super important to be subscribed to my channel, and super important to click the bell button, so you will know when my new video will come out. Okay, so let's continue. Make sure to check this video. It will help you to cut all these straps very easy, because maybe you make narrow straps, and to cut it accurately, you can use this approach. Okay, so check the link. So cut all the straps twice. You see, it's important to know that once you need to place this cardboard in one way to cut one half of the strap, then you need to turn over this cardboard pattern and cut it when it turned over. So when you attach two pieces together, you will attach the inner sides together and you will have identical straps. Okay, that's why it's better to turn over each strap when you cut twice same strap. Okay, this is how it will look if you will follow my guidance. Okay, you see how it looks? So each strap you need to cut twice, and then we will attach all the straps together. And after we will attach all the straps, we will cut extra using our basic patterns. Basic pattern of each strap. Okay, so we will attach inner side of each strap. Do not cover with glue your working place, your table, place some piece of paper and work on it with the glue. Here I used contact leather glue, neoprene glue. It has some smell, so be sure that you ventilate your room very well. Place glue on entire inner surface of each strap. It's very important because if you will not place it on entire surface, it will be difficult to attach well all these straps. After you place the glue on inner side of all the straps, you should wait approximately 10-15 minutes until glue will dry. In the meantime, while the glue is drying, we will make the pattern for the shoe sole. Now you need to know that usually shoes don't have straight shoe sole. In the toe area it lifted a little bit, so to create the sandals with this kind of effect where the toe is lifted above ground, we need to enlarge on 2 millimeters, approximately 2-3 millimeters, the shoe sole. Okay, that's why now we will make this pattern enlarged in the toe area. To make it, place the cardboard, copy the outline of the insole and enlarge the toe area approximately on 2 millimeters. Here, that's why I made this straight line in a distance of 1 centimeter from the edge, from the toe edge, marked 2 millimeters from the line of the insole, and used the bottom of the insole to create new line for the shoe sole. So because of this enlargement, we will be able to create a little bit lifted toe area of our sandal. Cut out this pattern of the shoe sole. Now you will see how it will look when we will attach our real sandals. You see, this is how it will be lifted in the toe area. After glue will dry, just attach all straps together. To attach it easier, bend the strap, leather strap in the center, and start to attach from one edge or from the center. If you don't have hammer, you can flatten the surface of the leather strap with spoon. Okay, now you see how I do it. Bend it in the center, attach one side of the strap, and then step by step attach second side of the strap. And if you have some hammer, you can flatten the surface with the hammer. We need to flatten it well because it must be attached well, and with the hammer we can do it very easy. So make sure that you attach well each strap. And then after we will attach all the straps, we will be able to cut extra of each strap. And this is how we'll have clean and accurate edge. So place each strap for each strap, large strap that belongs to this strap that you want to cut. And don't forget to mark all marks, the mark of elastic allowance, the mark of the holes. Now you see, it may have some non-straight parts of leather, so to make it very clean, with clean edge, you can burn with the lighter, and then if you want, you can color the edge so it will look very clean. Don't forget to transfer all marks, and then holes, you can, for the holes of buckle, you will need to enlarge a little bit the mark that we have for the buckle to enter the buckle, okay? And then skive this underline that we have on the strap that holds the buckle to attach it, and to have very, not very, but narrow loop here in this part. Not a loop, narrow layers of leather, okay? Then enter the buckle, after you place glue, enter the buckle and attach the edge of this loop. That's why here we enlarge our strap on 4 centimeters to hold this buckle. Here we have loop for the back strap. Also skive a little bit the edge, mark where it ends on the inner side of our leather strap, skive the edge as I told, so it not have too thick layers. Place the glue on both parts where we want to attach and bend it and attach this part of the loop. You see, because we skived, it has this thin edge. Now this strap, here in this strap, we need to create holes for the buckle to enter the strap that will hold our sandal on the feet. So if you have punctures, make these holes with the puncture. If you don't have puncture, check out another way how you can create holes. Here in this place, we will make sole for our sandal. In this tutorial, I used the vegetable tan leather, the belly part of vegetable tan leather, and it's this part, it not has great quality. I used this kind of leather for purpose because this leather is very soft, flexible, and easy to work with, especially if you are beginner in shoemaking. Okay, that's why I used this type of leather. It has thickness of 3 millimeters approximately, but it's very soft and it's very easy to cut. So you can use this type of leather as well in the beginning of your shoemaking learning. Later, when if you will decide to move on and make professional shoes like professional, it's better to use another type of leather, the back part of the height. Okay, this part is belly part. It's not so good leather. We can use it for some parts of the shoe, but not the shoe sole. Okay, so remember it. Make sure that you choose the right side of the leather and transfer each part of our sandal, the insole part and shoe sole, and cut it out. You see, it's flexible, very flexible and easy to cut. You see, I cut it very easy working with simple utility knife. But that's why you as a beginner in shoemaking can start with this type of leather. This is how it will look. You see, we enlarge a little bit our shoe sole, and we will be able to bend it in the toe area, so it will be lifted above the ground. Now we need to transfer to the insole each mark of the straps. to transfer these marks, make this kind of cuts on the insole pattern. So you will be able to mark it on the inner part of our insole. Make sure that you mark all these marks on the inner side of the insole and transfer, mark all these marks on the inner side of the insole. Now, in the front area of our shoe sandal, we will sand this place where we will attach the front straps. Why? Because we don't want to feel all the straps when during wearing the sandals. That's why we need to create a kind of curved space inside of our insole, so you will not feel the edges of the strap, the front straps of your sandals. Also, don't forget to mark all the marks with the needed color of the marker to know where to attach each strap. Okay, now with the Dremel, this another tool, not traditional tool that you can use during making of the sandals, to sand a little bit the inner part of the insole and create this kind of space to attach straps, so you will not feel the straps. Okay, now make sure that you choose right straps that will be attached correctly to the inner side of our sandals, and you will know it according to these marks that the straps that must be attached to the inner part have this mark. And place glue in the place where we have mark for lacing allowance. So place glue on the inner side of the straps until the mark that we have, and also place glue on the inner side of the insole and wait until glue will dry. In the meantime, you can place glue also on the places on the other parts of the straps. So make sure that you place and attach strap correctly. According to the inner mark of the sandal, you will know that it belongs to the inner side of the sandal, and start from the inner side. Okay, attach first strap, then second. You see, this is how you can check yourself that you attach correct side of the strap according to the mark of the inner side, and first attach the inner side of the strap, then the outer side of the strap, and hit well with the hammer. Now straps and the glue is dry, you can skive the edge of each strap until the edge of the insole. Why we need to skive it? This is how we usually work in making shoes. So although you sanded with the Dremel on the inner side of the insole and created the kind of space to attach in the space straps, you still need to skive it. First of all, it will be much better to attach to the sky surface the shoe sole, and second, you will also reduce the thickness of the strap and it will not extend from the shoe sole and you will not feel it. Okay, we need to skive it a little bit, and you can work here with your utility knife to skive it. So make sure to not place your fingers in front of the blade to not cut yourself, so be very careful. Also place glue on the place where you will attach the back part, the back strap, and before you will attach this back strap, you will need to enter the strap, white strap that holds the buckle, inside of this loop that the back strap has. This is the right moment. You will not be able to do it after you will attach all these straps. So remember to do it before you will move on, before you will attach the back strap. and also make sure that you place it correctly. Pay attention that the buckle must go from the heel. It must be on the heel part, okay? Not from the side of the instep. It must be on the side of the heel. Okay, you see the buckle goes on the side from the heel side, okay? Then attach all the straps to the insole. Hammer it. Here you see we have this fastening here. This is how it will look on the feet. And all the straps that we just attached, you need to scarf as well. Especially here in this place, you see, here we have few straps, two straps that attached one on the other. And if we will not scarf it, we will have very thick layers of leather straps. And later when you will attach the shoe sole, it will have big bump and maybe you will not be able to attach the shoe sole. So that's why you should scarf the straps well. And then you will need to place glue on the insole and on the shoe sole, on the inner part of the shoe sole, of course, using same glue, neoprene glue. For better attaching, you could put here two layers of the glue. Place one layer of the glue on both surfaces, on the surface of the insole and on the surface of the shoe sole. Wait until glue will dry and place second layer on both surfaces and wait until glue will dry. Place glue on entire surface. To attach it well, you need to put glue on the entire surface of the shoe sole and on the entire surface of the insole with the straps. Don't forget to ventilate your room because this glue has a strong smell. Now we'll make the tap of the heel. Here this part of our sandals, the tap, will be made from the same leather type that we used for the insole and sole. Okay, now usually the length of this step you can find very easy. Take the part, pattern of your insole, measure the widest placed in this area and add extra 5 millimeters. Here in this tutorial, this length that I got is 5.5 centimeters or even 6 centimeters. Make a central line, and here according to this central line you can measure with the ruler from one edge of the insole to another edge of the insole and find this center, dividing this distance on half to find the central line. And according to the central line, you will be able to change the shape of the step, make it with rounded shape, with any other shape. And working with center line, you will get symmetrical size of your heel, okay? Or make it with straight, simple line, like I did in this tutorial. Cut it out, and this is how you got the pattern for the tap that we will attach to the shoe sole. Cut it from leather. So after glue will dry, you can attach shoe sole to the insole. Start from the back edge of the insole. Following the edge of the insole, attach the shoe sole And here in this place, bend a little bit insole and attach sole according to the edge of the insole. And because we enlarge it a little bit, you can do this kind of effect where the toe of the sandal is lifted a little bit above the ground. Here you need to attach it well. To do so, you should hammer it well. You don't need to have any special hammer, use what you have. And now we will attach the heel. Before, mark the edge of the heel to know how to attach it. And before you place glue here on the shoe, so you can scratch it a little bit so it will be attached better. Also place glue to the inner side of the tab of your heel and wait until glue will dry. Also here you can use two layers of glue, and after glue will dry, attach this tab of the heel to the shoe sole. Press it well, hold it very well, and hammer it well, as you see I'm doing right now. Okay, now we are in the step of edge finishing. You can do it with same tool, Dremel drill. We should have smooth surface here where edge is straight, especially in this heel area. So when you will work with Dremel drill, don't forget to put mask and goggles, okay? And then after you will sand it with Dremel, you will have here even surface, and you can continue working on the edge of your sandals working with sandpaper. I used here very rough sandpaper. You can start with rough and then move on to a more gentle sandpaper, and you can use here different types of sandpaper, and that has numbers of grit. The higher number is, the more gentle sandpaper is. Okay, so here in this tutorial I used very rough sandpaper like 80, and then to make really beautiful edge of your sandals, you can use higher numbers of the sandpaper to sand it and get beautiful edge of the shoe sole. Okay, now what is important here to get this shiny look is to work with a little bit of water and sand in one direction when you will work with gentle sandpaper to create this beautiful smooth edge. Work in one direction. This is one of the secrets that shoemakers have when they want to create beautiful edge of the shoe sole. And this is how it will look when you will finish your sandals. That's it with this tutorial. Now, following all the steps that I explained here, you can create this kind of sandals or change it a little bit and create your own sandals working without any special equipment. You will need only your feet. Now, this tutorial is something different from what I do here in this channel, where I explain how to make shoes professionally. And if you want to know how to make real shoes, you are welcome to check my shoemaking courses online, where I have different courses, how to make sandals, moccasins, bespoke shoes with welted construction, and many other. So make sure to check a link that I placed in the description below this video. I have a question for you. Did you like this kind of tutorial where I upgraded my oldest tutorial, where I just showed the process without any explanation and added explanation? Because I have a lot of old tutorials with great information, very useful tips that I think you will benefit from all these tutorials. So if you like it and you want to see more of these tutorials, please comment below this video. I post new tutorials weekly. So if you like these tutorials and want to see more, Make sure to subscribe to my channel. And of course, don't forget to click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you and see you in the next video. Bye.